Initializing third newcomer training sequence. Greetings, Protector. Now that you've learned match essentials, we'll explore some important details like champion roles, damage types, artifact assembly, and champion skill combos. Champions are heavily defined by their role and damage type. Hold your cursor over a role or damage type while in the lobby to obtain further information. Roles provide a high-level overview of a champion's combat style and assist protectors in building a balanced team during the pre-match lobby phase. There are two damage types, attack and power. Most champions fight solely with one damage type, but certain champions, like Gaslight Batman, are hybrid with skills in both kinds of damage. A good mix of damage types makes a team more difficult to defend against. Understanding champion roles and damage types is essential to successful artifact assembly. For example, most marksmen rely on attack damage to be more effective. So, protectors want attack damage artifacts more than other artifacts that grant additional power damage. Likewise, if an enforcer champion faces power damage enemy champions, the acquisition of attack defense artifacts is far less effective. Expert protectors assemble artifacts based on their champion's damage type and role, and also that of their enemies. During the trials, protectors are inevitably defeated. The kill card allows you to review detailed information on the enemy or enemies involved in your demise. The information provided includes champion damage type and role, artifact graph, individual artifacts, skills used in your defeat, and overall numbers and percentages of damage. When multiple enemies assist in your defeat, their skills and overall damage are also included. Use this information to your benefit. Counter your enemy's strengths with future artifact purchases and claim victory from the ashes of defeat. Credits are dropped when drones are defeated, but protectors who last hit enemy drones with a finishing strike acquire those credits immediately without having to pick them up. Drones destroyed by structures drop significantly less credits, making it far less effective to gain credits while inside the firing range of allied control points or turrets. All sectors where trials take place will experience catastrophic events. These events, whether they are meteor impacts or supermassive energy bursts, alter the sector's environment. Protectors can influence the outcome of these catastrophic events, but only if their team manages to complete the built-in objectives found in every sector. Attack move causes a champion to auto-attack the first enemy unit or structure encountered while traveling to a targeted destination. Experienced protectors make expert use of attack move, especially when their chosen champion is equipped with skills that enhance basic attacks. As a ranged champion, click away from a melee champion and alternate between left-clicking to move and pressing A and left-clicking to attack move. Effective use of this tactic allows you to consistently damage melee enemies while maintaining a range advantage. All champions have a skill set capable of powerful combos. Learning your preferred champion's combos, but also the combos of your enemy and allied champions, is yet another way to ensure your continued victory. You have many stolen powers to choose from, and as you fight with champions, you will unlock additional stolen powers. Optimal usage of stolen powers depends on the role and overall playstyle of your chosen champion. Enforcers benefit greatly from Consume Matter, a stolen power that heals its user. But marksmen will often find invulnerability a beneficial stolen power when facing a surprise enemy attack. The end of game overview screen contains useful information about everyone's overall match performance and is a good place to chat with your fellow protectors. Showing good sportsmanship in the chat window can make new friends who often turn into powerful future teammates. This concludes the third newcomer training sequence.